Guys, if you have a calendar tool or a booking tool where you want to get leads and you are using Google Ads to get those leads, you better make sure that your conversion tracking is absolutely on point, because it's a lot more now about us teaching the AI systems where to find the results versus us tinkering with the controls and telling the AI systems where the results are. I see mistakes around this made all the time. I'm going to go through a process and you can get set up. So guys, stick around. That's exactly what we're going to do today. Hello, our gang, and welcome back. It's your boy Jerry coming at you with a brand new video. And today we are going to be looking at how to use Google Tag Manager to set up a really simple lead conversion tracking using a Google Tag Manager and a custom thank you page. Okay, so you're going to know exactly how to connect your calendar or your booking application to Google Tag Manager that then feeds back into Google Ads, so it has the strongest potential to optimize as much as it can. Okay, guys, like I said many, many times, it's a lot less about us tinkering with the controls and a lot more now about us setting up the data touch points so that we can teach the AI systems exactly about our conversion process so that they can go and find us better results. Okay, so this is what we're going to be looking at today to ensure that the attribution and the data that is going back into your Google Ads system, back into Google Analytics, is as accurate as it can be. And that way, we know that the conversion tracking and all the ads that we're building on top of this conversion tracking is working, and that every dollar or pound that we spend is developing the ad AI and is developing our machine learning so we can go and find us better results. So it's very, very important that we get these fundamentals right so we can build on, and everything that we do has an impact in the best possible way. So we're going to go through the very, very basic setup of how to do this. Guys, the main thing that you're going to need for this setup is going to be your booking tool, the Google Tag Manager, the Google Ads Manager. And the fourth thing we need is a URL which links to that thank you page, okay? /thank you, for example. With those four components, we can get started. So guys, sit back, relax, grab your coffees, grab your hats. Let's spin up some ad magic. Okay guys, so like I said, the first thing that we'll need is a booking tool or a place where potential leads can schedule appointments with you, okay? So some of you may be familiar with Calendly. Within each booking system, typically, there is a section under confirmation page where you can select page redirect. Okay, I'm going to show you exactly where that is on Calendly. So I've just selected the specific calendar that I'm going to be directing people to. And then under here, under booking page options, I'm going to select here, I'm going to scroll all the way down. And here, under confirmation page, it says after booking, what do you want to do? Do you want to display the default Calendly confirmation page? Or do you want to direct your lead to a custom thank you page? Okay, this is what we need to do. We need to direct people back to our website to a custom thank you page where we have the conversion tracking added there, okay? So that's what we're gonna select here. You're gonna select redirect to an external site. If you're not using Calendly, it will be something very, very similar to this, okay? You click on there, you add in the custom link at the bottom. So that means when a lead has booked a calendar appointment with you, they get automatically redirected to the custom thank you page that you have built on your website. For example, this is the one that we've built and we'll be using in the example today. It's just a basic thank you page. We need to set up the conversion tracking. So that's what we're going to do. Okay. Now we're going to move over to Google Tag Manager. Google Tag Manager. Okay. So I'm going to go under the presumption that you haven't added anything here. So if you'd like to skip ahead, there's a timestamp below. So you don't need to go and do the initial setup for this. But we're going to go, for those people who don't know, we're going to go through the setup for tags and triggers and a variable, which is very, very important. First of all, we're going to set up all the default tags that need to be added here on Google Tag Manager as a standard, as a foundation. Okay, so we're going to hit new. You're going to hit tag configuration. You're going to click Google Ads, and we're basically going to add in each of these. Okay, so we're going to add each of these into the account. So I'm going to start off with the conversion linker. This is the most simple one. I typically accept the incoming linker parameters. This means if the user journey gets redirected to another URL, e.g. the Calendly URL, that the information still gets fed back into the conversion system. I have this ticked under the name of it. What I would do is just call it Google Conversion Linker. As a trigger, just select all pages here and then select save. That is the Google Conversion Linker implemented. Now we need the Google Ads user provided data event in there. Under conversion ID, this is when we need to go back to your Google Ads Manager. click on goals, click on summary, select the main conversion goal that you're optimizing for, open it up, open up the settings, scroll down to the very bottom. Under tag setup, click use Google Tag Manager, and here you'll see the conversion ID that we need to add in. Okay, this will be the main conversion that you are optimizing for in your campaigns. This is the conversion ID, and then we can add that in to our Google Tag Manager. Under Google Ads, user provided data, event, we're going to click add trigger. You're going to scroll to trigger type. You're going to scroll down to form submission, this one here. And you're just going to select all forms, okay? Just title it as all forms, click save. And then that means that the Google Ads user provided data event gets submitted via all forms. That's that section done. And guys, final tag that we need to add in. So we go to a new tag. Here we go to Google Analytics. Under Google Analytics, we just type in Google Analytics 4. We need to add in here our Google Analytics measurement ID. So in order to find the measurement ID for Google Analytics 4, what we're going to do is you're just going to go to Google Analytics. You're going to scroll down here or on the left-hand side to admin. Then you're going to go to here to data streams. Okay, you're going to select your main data stream that you will have installed. And here on the very right-hand side, we have measurement ID. Okay, so we're going to copy that and we're going to add this into our Google Tag Manager. This makes sure that everything is being fired. And under triggering, we're just going to select all pages for that to ensure that the Google Analytics tag fires on all the pages as it should. Now, these Google Analytics tags are quite fiddly to set up. If you want to set up an event name, you can add in the additional information for what we're looking at within this name. I'll just leave that as false for now. So as we're setting this up under the Google Analytics for event, you've added in your measurement ID, select false here. And under the event name, just select the event name that's going to get fed into Google Analytics 4. Okay, so for this particular one, I think the main applicable event here listed as a default is generate lead, right? This is somebody who's given us their lead details. So that's it, guys. Then you click save and just rename it, you know, Google Analytics GA4 tag and hit save. That should be absolutely fine. But guys, before we go any further and you're new here, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe to make sure that you don't miss any future important updates. We are here every single week to make sure that business owners, entrepreneurs, advertisers, digital marketeers, and social media strategists know exactly the latest features and tools that they need to get the latest from their online advertising, paid media, and digital marketing strategies. But without further ado, let's get back into the video. Now we need to add in our Google Ads conversion tracking. We're going to select this. It's going to give you a few different options here. And what we need to do at this stage is go to our Google Ads Manager. So go to your main conversion action that you want your campaign to orientate itself around. Click on this conversion goal and it will bring up the setting details. So we want to scroll down to tag setup. You want to select use Google Tag Manager. And what you want to do, there is a conversion ID number and a conversion label. So we're going to add this very simply into Google Tag Manager. This is the main conversion goal that the whole campaign is orientated around, the book appointment conversion. This could be submitted lead. This could be reach thank you page. This could be, you know, we could label it, but the main conversion action really is a lead has submitted their details, booked a call with you and registered their interest with their details. That's the main conversion action that is happening here. So however you set that up in the Google Ad Manager, that is completely fine. So all we want to do is just make sure that the main conversion action that is in the Google Ads that we're directing our campaign to and paying for traffic to is that the conversion ID for this goal is linked to Google Tag Manager. And this is what you do that here. There's actually one more thing that needs to be added into the settings for this conversion tracking. So I'm going to come off this. I'm going to label this the Google Ads conversion tracking. I'm going to hit save for now. And then we're going to come down here into variables. So guys, you want to make sure in the variables section that you've got all the variables selected. Under configure, make sure that the top 5 points are selected. This means that when we go to add the tag, under the tag settings, click include user provided data from your website. And if it's not already selected, make sure that you select user provided data. Okay guys, so it's very important to set up those variables when you go to add in the associated trigger for the tag. Okay, so trigger configuration, page view, some page views, page URL, and then page URL contains, and then you add in the thank you page that we have for our booking process. Okay, so page view, and then you add in your trigger name, and that's it, guys. That's how you add the tag and the trigger, okay? That means that now the trigger gets activated every time somebody lands on your thank you page URL, and the tag that gets fired is has the conversion ID that you have linked from Google Ads Manager, okay? So everything's now linked, and there's just a few more steps that we need to complete in order to finish this. Now, the next one, you're going to go and do the same thing for Google Ads Remarketing. We're going to have to set up the Google Ads Remarketing, and this is going to be basically the same setup as the initial Google Ads conversion tracking that we've just set up. Okay, so exactly the same process. So that's why I'm going to add in my conversion ID and my conversion label, again, from the Google Ads Manager, the same conversion that I am orientating my whole campaign around, okay, booking that conversion. So if yours is slightly different, if your ad journey looks slightly different, then I would suggest doing it bespoke to what you're trying to achieve. But this is basically how I've set this up. So we add in our conversion ID and our conversion labels there. So that's then your Google conversion ads tracking setup. You've got your remarketing ads tracking setup. You've got your Google Analytics 4 event firing. And you've got the user generated details coming in as well to enhance the data that gets fed into the Google systems. Now, something very, very important. There's two steps left to this. I'm going to go through right now. There is two final things that we need to consider before this is absolutely finalized. So I'm going to do that right now. After everything has been set up nicely, we're going to hit up here. We're going to hit preview because we need to put a test booking in to make sure that all of the conversion tags are firing correctly. Okay, so we're just going to try doing that. You're going to press connect. It's going to open up. You're going to go through the booking process. And then after you've gone through the booking process on Calendly, it's going to redirect you back to your thank you page. Then you're going to go back to Google Tag Manager, and you're going to make sure that the main conversion that you set up is firing. So the main one that we set up here is main thank you page. That is, we can see here under tags fired, this is firing correctly. If you scroll down, you can also see the tags not fired. So if it hasn't appeared up here, make sure to check the tags not fired and re-implement those if they are not firing correctly, and then test again to make sure that they are appearing here under tags fired. So that's how you do that, ladies and gentlemen. That is the testing. Everything is firing okay. Everything is looking good. The very, very final thing, when we're very happy with everything, how everything has been set up, you're going to go back, come back to Google Tag Manager, and here on the very top right-hand side, you're going to press submit, and you're going to submit your changes. This is super important, guys. If you don't submit your changes, then what you've just implemented won't come into effect, okay? So make sure that you hit submit, and make sure that you save the changes that you've just made, okay? And guys, that's it. Now you have the full working process with conversion tracking, from a booking form to a thank you page. That data gets fed to Google Tag Manager, which then acts as the middleman to get fed into Google Ads and Google Analytics. This is a great hack. We use this a lot with a lot of the personal brands that we work with, any businesses where there is lead generation or there's some kind of book appointment, book consultation. This is the strategy that we utilize for that, okay? This is how we can track conversions. This is how we get the best from our data for the ad AI systems to learn and maximize our results. Okay, so really cool, guys. Hope that was interesting for you. Hope that was nice. And yeah, let me know what you think. But that's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for being here. I really, really appreciate you joining me on this path of discovery and learning. I'd love to hear what you think, whether or not you think that this is a good tactic, whether or not you've utilized tactics that are equally easy to implement and are just as effective. We utilize this strategy across many of our clients. So I'd really love to know if this working for you, if you have different approaches to this, or what you think to this process in general, using Google Tag Manager to measure and feed the data back into Google Ads. So I'd love to hear what you think. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe. It really helps me and other forward thinkers just like you get the best of their business too. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you never miss any updates. If you've made it this far into the video, give me a comment down below with a hell yeah to show me that you're still having a good time. If you'd like to see another video on how to create a YouTube ad that helps you grow your YouTube subscribers through Google Ads, click here. You can follow me on socials at Jerry Dreadlocks, on LinkedIn at Jerry Griffiths. Thank you so much for being here. I'm Jerry the Ad Wizard, and wherever you are in the world, I bid you peace, love, a wonderful rest of your day, and as always, I will catch you in the next one.